I've been through a lot, you know, I'm going through a lot still, always. I've gotten more confident in accepting the fact that I have a severe visual impairment, which I'm pretty sure you figured out when you saw the little Chinese girl help me get on stage. You probably figured that out pretty fast. As Bing Lai, I found her on Craigslist. Incredibly effective. Very thorough. Stronger hands than I expected, but still unbelievably productive. Yeah, it's a wild ride I'm on right now, you know? 10 years ago, I did the album Blind Ambition and turned into a big comedy special. Changed my life. And the theme of that was, you know, I've always had bad eyes, but then I was afraid there was deterioration to total blindness. So I came to Vancouver and had a surgery, and that stemmed off the blindness. And I had these crazy suicidal thoughts because I didn't want to depend on people if I was totally blind. And as life dictates, 10 years later, I'm blind. No odds. It's what it is. And so, but I'm not scared. Not only do I not want to die, I mean, the life part of it is incredible. What I'm doing now is off the chain. You know what's made the big difference is stop being selfish. I'll say it again. Stop being selfish. One more time. Stop being selfish. It's not about what's wrong with you. It's about accepting what's wrong with you because it's not really wrong, and allowing people time to adjust. Because once they can accept that you're comfortable with you, then they'll be comfortable with you. Like after the show, I like to meet as many as you possibly can. But don't be embarrassed, because a lot of times people get embarrassed. Like, oh, I don't know if he can see me when I want to shake his hand. Well, I can't see your handshake, so you have to actually put your hands on me so I can shake your hand. Otherwise, I'm going to miss your handshakes. I'll step on some toes. I'll squeeze some titties on accident. This is just the cross that I carry. This is the burden that I walk around with. There are some times I think I'm at the elevator reading Braille. Nope. Areola bumps. Is this the fifth floor or? Okay, wait. Is this fifth floor? Wait. Are you telling me this is not the button I'm supposed to be pushing for the fifth floor? I'm trying to buy a slow cooker. This is not the button for that? I'm understanding of that, and it's okay. You know, I mean, there's so many times in my life where the universe has taught me more than I thought I knew, which is a weird concept, but you have to allow people time, right? And because once I get one, now that I am comfortable with it, I'm okay with a lot of things. Sometimes people get uncomfortable with it and I have to give them time. Like I was catching a cab in Toronto and I heard the cab dispatch say to the driver, driver, he's visually impaired. So you have to say his name and he will walk towards the vehicle. So I'm standing outside. I hear Daryl, Daryl, Daryl. I start walking towards the car. Daryl? Yes, cab driver? Yes, hop in. So I just hop in. So I grab the door handle and I get in. Turns out I grab the driver's side of the fucking car and I sat on the driver's face. Whole ass on this dude's fucking face. Bam! And I don't wear underwear. So it was like balls, thin denim, cheekbone. Boom. I could feel his turban move all the way. And that's not racist. He could have wore a Yankees hat or a yarmulke. I still move that motherfucker. Dude, he went from Punjab to pimp. And where are my bitches now? Where are my bitches now? And this is all he said. This is all he said. He just goes, no. No, 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 no. And I thought, oh my God, this dude's belief system is incredible. Allah is stronger than Jesus. Because I grew up Christian. I don't know, Christian world would let a nigga sit on his face in a cab, and all he's going to say is, no, 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 no. And then I sit in the back, and I realize, oh, man, I got to tip the shit out of this dude. You just can't teabag a dude and give him a standard 10%. This is a 75, 85% tip. I got to break this dude off. And then I realize, man, I fucked this dude's day up. He's got to go home and explain to his wife why he's grumpy and where that extra money came from. How was your day today? I used to be an engineer in the old country. And today, a black anus straddle my face. Have you ever had an anus straddle your face? Yes, last night for your birthday when you asked me to do the thing that you're like, that is not what I am talking about. But thank you, it was sweet. And then I sat in the back and I thought, thank God that I was in Canada and not in Florida, because those stand your ground motherfuckers would have shot my asshole clean off the bone. I would have been taintless in Tampa looking for help. Hi, my name is Daryl. I had my taint blown off in a horrible taxicab accident. Welcome, Daryl. Here's your special pillow.